ओके, आई फॉरगॉट टू रिकॉर्ड माय स्पॉट. सो स्टैट प्रो स्टैंड फॉर स्ट्रक्चर एनालिसिस एंड डिजाइन सॉफ्टवेयर. तो इफ यू सी हियर, वी आर गोइंग टू आवर न्यू प्रोजेक्ट दिस वन. सो वी सिलेक्ट द स्पेस ऑप्शन. आई एम स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट. वी आर सिलेक्टिंग द स्पेस ऑप्शन बिकॉज इन स्पेस वी आर द 3D स्ट्रक्चर. वी विल गिव अ नेम, CIVL 4111 सेक्शन बी. आई हैव सिलेक्टेड माई लोकेशन. आई हैव सिलेक्टेड माई फाइल, द फोल्डर दैट इज सामर प्रोजेक्ट अंडर एफ ड्राइव. एंड आई हैव सिलेक्टेड माई द लेंथ यूनिट्स इन मीटर, दैट इज एसआई यूनिट एंड किलो न्यूटन. एंड आई विल गो टू नेक्स्ट. नाउ बाई क्लिकिंग नेक्स्ट देर इज अनदर पॉप अप विंडो विच इज कमिंग. Now, if you want to make some changes after going to this next, if you feel that, oh my God, I've done some mistake, you can go to this back option also. Back option will bring you to this window, this pop-up box. Okay. These are known as pop-up box. Go to next. So there are many options. Add beam, add plate. I told you by adding plate, that means we can only draw plate option. Or plates, add solid. Solid will be sometimes if you're drawing your sorry, pardon, your shear wall, your retaining walls, bridge deck, all these things. But solid and plates both can be used for same purpose. Okay? Solid or plate both can be used the same purpose. Open structural wizard. Structural wizard is a prefixed area, or it is a library area where we have ready-made structure. You have ready-made structures like you have ready-made beams, ready-made plane frames, 3D frames, 2D trusses, 3D trusses. We have cooling towers, everything. Just you have to give some dimension, height, length, width. If you give this dimension, automatically they will create. Okay, so structural wizard is basically similar to an area I taught you during AutoCAD days, that we have something called tool palettes. We have something called tool palettes. In tool palettes, we have a lot of ready-made diagrams. Also in tool palettes and your design center, DC. If you go to design center in AutoCAD, you will get a lot of already created diagrams. Like you have, for example, you have trees, cars. Also, you have some interiors like architectural part, kitchen, toilet, everything. Similarly, open structural wizard is basically an area where you can create ready-made structure if you provide some values of damage. If you do not click here, if you go to add beam, also if you go to add beam and open your own Stat Pro window, there also structured wizard option is there. Okay, so don't worry, you're not missing your structural wizard disadvantage. Whenever we go to Stat Pro window, there is an option of structural wizard. Okay, I will teach you that, but much later. So we will always go for add beam. Add beam is basically universal. You can draw beam, columns, everything. Okay. Sometimes what happens, you can also draw plates and plate surfaces and solids, because this plate surface solid, there are similar to like this. They are similar to this part. And just like a page has four edges, a page is a plate. You can imagine a page is a plate. So these plates have four edges. So all these edges will be done by beams. Okay. So that is why in this add beam interface, if add beam option, your interface will allow you to draw any sort of item. It may be truss, maybe anything. So add beam, then finish. So see here, by finishing this, automatically, this is my whole screen or window or interface of your Stat Pro. Now see, you can see a grid. We can see a grid 10 by 10, you can see 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3. That is by default 0 to 10 in the, if you see the left bottom corner, first you see the left bottom corner. You see the left bottom corner, what you can see? We have x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis coming outward. Okay, x-axis, z-axis, and x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis coming outward. That means automatically when you open a window, your this 2D grid will be placed on XY plane. On XY plane, it will be placed. This is by default. Okay. Whenever you open a window. Now, if you select here, you go to create. Okay. So this is basically a grid. If you as a just a beginner, we do not need this grid actually. Whenever we draw any building plan or any structural drawing, we do not go for this grid. This is for basic beginners. Okay. There are three different grids you can use. How to find out? See here. This grid is there. This cursor is blinking. This cursor here is X cursor. Okay. Here it is X cursor. See here. In the right side, we have snap node beam. We have the snap node or beam pane. This panel is called snap node or beam panel. Here it is tick mark, it is written default grid. It is a default grid of 10 by 10 meter with intervals of 1 meter. Along x-axis, see if you can check along x-axis, we have 1 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter interval. And along y-axis it is 1 meter, 1 meter till 10. Okay, so this is by default. You can increase or decrease. How we can see? Just see here. Whatever the option I'm doing here, just see here. So I'm going to the snap node beam, and see here we have x, y. We have x, y, correct? Now frequency, you can increase. You can add increase the frequency. You just check. I'm increasing the frequency to 2. That means an interval of 2 meters, 2 meter, 2 meter, 2 meter. Okay. So just see here. I have changed my x-axis. The frequency is 2, and see the grid. Just check the grid. My grid has changed into 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay. Similarly, we can go for y-axis. For example, I have done for y. Okay. For y also, if you check at 2 meter intervals, my markings are given. Are you able to understand? Very interesting. So I am bringing back to the original part. Now we can also increase. You can also increase the intervals. Okay. Also, you can also increase the intervals. You can go for now. This see this again. This default grid. You click this. It is already clicked. It is also select. It is already selected actually. This default grid that is linear. You go for edit. We can. We have to. We want to edit this division. We want to make 20 division along x-axis and along y-axis 30 division. Okay. So what will you do? Your option will be selected. Your option will be selected. You make edit. After edit, first of all, you can change the plane. You can put XY plane, XZ plane, YZ plane. So see, very interestingly, when I'm changing this plane, similarly along that plane, my grid is getting oriented. Okay, my grid is getting oriented in that plane only. So X will it be XY plane. If you want to make a vertical member, a vertical track, then you can go for XY plane. If you want to make a floor, a surface element or any floor element where it will be lying on a horizontal plane, then you can select this XZ plane. Similarly, YZ plane. vertically. So you can change all these things. You can change the origin also. Here our origin is XYZ 0 comma 0 comma 0. Now in AutoCAD, sorry, in Stat Pro, we have to always keep in mind there. We have to always keep in mind the concept of Cartesian coordinates in X, Y, and Z, three perpendicular orthogonal axes. We have to, whatever the nodes or whatever the points we have to remember, we have to imagine, we have to visualize based on the Cartesian coordinate along three different orthogonal axes, X, Y, and Z axis. Okay. Now coming to this part. So if I want to make X about 11 intervals, see automatically it has gone 11. I want to make it 20. See along 20, see along X axis, we have 20 number of grids. See here, 20 number of grids. All these things. Achha. Along with this, if you want to make, you move the screen, just like in AutoCAD, whenever we used to right click, we had the pan option, hand option, this hand. Pan option, we can move the screen. But here during the right click, doing this right click, we are not getting any pan option. This, just wait a minute. Yeah. I'm doing this right click, is not coming. Okay, this right click is not coming, right? Okay. I don't know, it is not showing in the screen. But if you do the right click, there is no pan option or hand option, okay? So you have to select this hand from here. See, the second row of control bar. The second row, you select the hand option, a pan option, and you can move it. Similarly, you can move it like this, okay? So from the hand option, that is from the second line, we have the pan. It's called pan option. Okay. Pan option. We also have magnifying glass. We also have magnifying glass. Okay. We also have magnifying glass to find out all these things. To find out all these things. Okay. Magnifying glass. All these things. Okay. Also, if you want, for example, I will show you by and by. So this is basically a equi, this is called linear grid. Okay. If you go to edit, here we have three different types. If you go to create, actually, sorry. If you see the right side panel, if you select this create option, there are three different modes. We have linear. Check here. I hope this will is observable. Linear, radial, and irregular. Okay, there are three different options which comes. I don't know why it is not coming in the screen. Actually, in my screen it is showing, but I don't know, it will not be shown in on your screen actually. You select this default grid and select on this create. At the topmost, if you click on this down arrow, there are three different forms: linear, radial, and irregular. Radials means circular. See, radial will be circular. Radial will be circular in a circular manner. Sometimes it can be circular. It can be, if you are developing a structure like pentagon, hexagon, any polygonal structure, if you want to create, you can use this radial option. And if the intervals are irregular spaced, they have to go for irregular. Okay. So all these things we can. Now, if you go to create, if you, for example, I show you the some linear. Okay. I select the linear and make okay. Okay. Radial. And I create okay on exit plane. Radius. For example, I'm doing some values. I will give a name. A very important, also by selecting the mode of option, I have to give a name. For example, I'm giving the name radial 2 and clicking it OK. Now, if you go to the right hand side in the snap node or beam panel, just select this radial. See, automatically this radial has come. Automatically this radial option has come. There are different radials. Okay, there are different radials. The first one is the radius one, the bigger one. See, the biggest radius is known as the radius. We have these are the base, the center to center distance between these joints, they're called base. We have two type of radius. We have radius one and radius two. Okay, so all these things, we can change the interval of this radius. So this is a radial form of grid. So grid are of three different options: radial, irregular, and regular. Sorry, radial, linear, and irregular. In the linear option, we can provide intervals with equal interval. In irregular, the intervals can be different. And in radial, we can create a plan which can be in a circumferential in a circular manner. In a circular manner means it not always that we can draw only arches or circular beams or arches, but also you can draw any polygonal structure. Okay. So again, come back. So we will close this thing. We will close this thing. So as a civil engineer, we do not need all these grid options, all these linear, irregular, and radial. We will directly put these nodes. That means we will directly put the coordinates of x, y, and z axis. And similarly, by putting these coordinates, my dots will be produced. These are called nodes. Nodes, I told you, nodes can be the joining point of two beams. Node can be joining point of beam and column. Node can be support ends. Okay, support. So all these things are there. Now, so if let us first directly going into the node, let me show you the this is basically the we have another thing that is, this is called basically graphical user interface, GUI. We also have CUI, that is command user interface. That means all the commands which you have selected or all the commands which you have used, they are listed under this option. See, stat editor. This is known as stat editor. So whatever you have used, all your commands, what you have done, everything, you will just select this option, stat editor. Whenever you will click, a window will come. A window will come. Here it is not displaying in your screen. A window will come, and this window contains all the commands, line by line commands, that whatever you have implemented, that is displaying in this screen, which is not displaying in your screen, I know, because it is a secondary window. The primary window is StatPro. The primary window is StatPro. I will show you the stat editor after drawing some model. The stat editor, we can do a printout of. Okay. By doing stat editor, so during your Viva time, something will be given to write some commands, line by line command. In AutoCAD, we have command prompt where all the commands are written sequentially, the way we have used it. Similarly, here we have stat editor, EDITU. What is the use of the stat editor? If, for example, we have done any development in the structure and you need to make some changes, so you can directly go to stat editor and you remove the old commands and you can put some new alterations. So stat editor is a very useful thing which we can use to make some alterations in our programming or in our use of commands. Okay. Now, if you see, now let me draw, let me, for example, let me make some points, some nodes on this frame. Okay. For example, so we have to give all the coordinates based on x coordinate, y coordinate, and z coordinate. So first will be 0, 0, 0. If you just put 0 and enter, all the three different will be 0. If you select C here, if you just put in the x-axis 0 and press enter, all will be 0. Okay. So my first point will be 0, 0, 0, 0. And if you see here, I have the dot. Again, let me take along x-axis, let me take 3 meter. 3, 0, 0. Let me take 6, another point at 6 meter with reference to origin, 6 meter along x-axis. Now, let me take x 0, y 3 meter. Y 3 meter. See? Now, in y-axis, it will be 3 meter. It will be 6 meter, all these things. Similarly, let me, so by and by, I'm putting the dots. Putting the dots meaning I'm putting, just like in a graph paper, we plot the coordinates. Similarly, here we are plotting coordinates. And this is a very basic and essential part in STATIC. Okay. So just I want to make some basic 2D structure. So I have done till now six nodes. And similarly, if you go to STAT editor, if you go to STAT editor, if you just open in your software, it is not showing here. I have joint coordinates. I have some joint coordinates which is shown. Shown, okay. After completing my grid formation, I will show you how a STAT editor looks. Okay. So all these things, then so since I have a very good visualization in X, Y, Z axis, you can put all these things. Okay. Now, very importantly, if you select any node, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Till now, we have created 6 different nodes. Okay. So if you select any node, that node will be blinking. See? Here, the node will be blinking. Node will be blinking. Similarly, 3, 3, 0. Similarly, if you use 3, 6, 0. Okay. So see here, I have done 9 different points. I have done my 9 different points. I have created 9 different coordinates using my X, Y, and Z coordinates concept. So this is the basic thing. This is basically the center. Whenever we get a plan, we get a plan of our building, and the center line. If you so, we are number of drawings we require. First is center line of columns, center line of column diagram. Second is we have beam slab layout, the beam slab layout diagram. These two diagrams you will require to develop the model in STATIC. Center line of columns, the center line of columns will be this node. Okay. These nodes and the beam slab layout, after I draw the beams, I will show you. Okay. So now I have drawn 9 different nodes. If I click one of them, the nodes, that particular node, if you see here, they will be highlighted by red line, by red dot. See here, they will be highlighted by red dot. Now I will use an option called add beam. Now I will create beams and polygons. Okay, first I will create beam. So how will I create beam? So I will create beam using add beam option. Add beam. So where will I get add beam? There are two ways we can go for add beam. So you can write in your copy that add beam option. Any problem you can tell me here in the class only. I'm getting some WhatsApp. Anyone? Those who have interview or something like that, just speak up in the class. Please speak up. Don't send me in WhatsApp because I'm busy. Anyone in the interview class, those who have interview, please speak up. Instead of sending me WhatsApp, please speak up. Anyone listening to my class also?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Those who have interview, those who are interview, please speak up. Instead of writing in the chat box, please speak up. Tell me the roll numbers you have interviewed at least. Okay, no one is speaking up, so I may proceed with my class. Please don't write in the chat box. Okay, it's very clumsy. It's very clumsy. Please don't write in the chat box. Okay, I'm just calling the names. Who have the interview? I'm making the note of the roll numbers as an attendance purpose. Roll number? Don't write in the chat box. Speak up.
121.
Louder?
121. Yes, sir.
Sir, 155.
121. What is your name? 121. What is your name?
Arsalan.
Arsalan. Okay. Next one.
55.
Name?
Om Prakash Chaudhary.
Om Prakash. Which company you have today?
Ha, sir.
Which company sir, you have today?
K12.
Huh?
K12.
Oh, sir. Okay, all the best. Next roll number. Any student? No one. Okay. Orgodeep is not there. Okay.
Sir, amake kalke inform korechilo Anirban.
Anirban at least last to join korlo na, so since he hasn't, he has called me once, but I was busy, so he could have just joined for a few minutes actually. Okay, understand. Okay, anyways, so come back to the class. So I have drawn 9 different nodes. Okay, I think those who have Stat Pro, you can do this thing, very interesting. Now, the thing which I drawing how to draw a node, I have showed you. So, this is I have drawn a node from my mind. Now, if we are going to learn this software to design a building, okay, building project. So, what do you need? You need a center line of columns, very important. Center line of columns is very important. Next is that we have beam slab. These two diagrams is a basic diagram you should have, okay? And based on this center line of columns, you have to take a copy. You have to make, for example, you have 4 different rows of 3 columns each. 3 into 4, 12 columns. So there are C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6. So you will get about 12 different columns. I will send you some basic. A typical center line of column, I will send you in the mail. as a practice material. So you take the single line of columns, you take out your copy, and you just make a list of x, y, and z coordinates just the way I have inserted here. Just you make the 12 different columns, and then you put the values in your copy and use those values here in this panel box, that is the nodes box. Okay. Just so there are 12 different columns will be, there are 12 different nodes, absolutely. And you will put the values of x, y and coordinates starting from the x. Okay. Now, let me show you. Now, after this, I will show you a different views of this window. What are the different views in the Stat Pro window? Before that, I will show how to create a beam. How to create a beam, how to add a beam. Okay. The same way we can create beams, we can create columns. So basically, beam and column, they are classified as member element. Please, member element is a word which the Stat Pro understands. Okay. Stat Pro understands this language, member element. Okay. Member element. So what is the thing? We have to go, now add beams. So how to add beams? There are two ways. First is if you check the third row, leftmost option, add beams. Either you can select, click this option and you can add beam. We can add beam from node to node by joining node to node. Okay. So you can just select this. You can just select this option. Your cursor, see your cursor has changed. The cursor has changed to arrow sign with beam. Okay. And now you can select from one node to the other. Again, one node to the other. Again, one node to the other. Like this, you can add beams one by one. This is one way of selecting the add beam option. Again, I am showing you. For undoing, you can do Control Z. Okay. The Control Z and undo and redo both works the same way. Okay. Undo redo is in the top. If you see the top control panel, if you see the undo and redo option. Here also we have some of the options are very much similar to AutoCAD. Some of the arrangement of various options, they are similar to AutoCAD. So undo, redo, you can do Control Z. Okay. Now, another way. First way I told you that we will go to this third row, leftmost corner. See here, if you are, those who are using some cell phone, you can enlarge your screen. If you see this option, click on this. Okay, click on this. And you join one beam to the other. One beam to other beam. One beam to other beam. Like, we can draw vertical. We can draw horizontal beams. We can draw. By and by, similarly, there's an auto save option will come. Okay. Stat Pro, if you put Control S as save, obviously it will be saved. Or else, AutoCAD, Stat Pro is such a very fine software. It prompts me this message after every 15 to 20 minutes. Do you want to proceed? Do you want to save? Yes. Structure has been modified. Yes, save. So if you do not save this project, Stat Pro automatically asks you. So you have to select yes and save. Okay. Or else you can do Control S, or you can option, you can select the save option from the here also, the top. Okay. So what I was telling that using the add beam, we can draw vertical lines, horizontal lines, and also inclined lines. For class members, we will do inclined beam. Okay. Now, how to delete a beam? Just select on this beam and press delete. Select on this beam, press delete. See what it is telling me? Option will come. A pop-up message will come. What is this? The message is one beam and an associated beam will be deleted. One beams and associated physical beams, if any, that means if there is one beam supporting on the other beam, if the primary beam, just see my screen, if the primary beam and there is another beam supporting on that beam, if they are joined along with primary beam, I have an associated secondary beam. Then if I delete the primary beam, automatically my secondary beam, which is the physically associated beam, as mentioned here, that will be deleted. Understand? So here, since here only one beam is there, so press delete. Okay. Do you want to delete? Now, after deleting the beams, another option will come. Deleting beams has left some nodes with no structural element attached. Do you want to delete the nodes? They also ask, do you want to delete the nodes? No. I am telling that I do not want to delete the nodes, only I want to delete the beam. So this is a way you can delete the beam. Again, I am showing you, you select the beam, press delete. There is no other way you can delete the beam, okay? There is no other erase option. Nothing is there in StatTool. Okay. In AutoCAD, we have two ways to delete. Either delete option, delete that keyboard from the delete option from keyboard, or selecting the erase option. Okay. So you select the beam, press delete. Okay. Do you want to delete the nodes? No, don't want to delete the nodes. So no option. So my nodes will be remaining intact. Okay, my nodes will be remaining intact. So this is the one way I showed you how to create a beam and how to add a beam and how to delete a beam. Understood, everyone? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, another way we can add the beam. See. I told you one way we can use this add button, add beam option. Another is you go to geometry. See, there are at the topmost control panel, at the top. We have what are the options we have? We have file, we have edit, we have view, tools, select, geometry. So geometry, when you will click it, when you click the geometry, again, the same things are there. Nodes, snap nodes, insert node, add beam. So here also you can add beam. Here we are getting a number of extra options. Just like in AutoCAD, if we select circle from the left side button, the left column from the screen, only you can draw circle using one to two options. That is a radius, that is center and radius, or center and diameter. But if you go to the top panel and select the draw toolbar in AutoCAD, draw toolbar, you select the circle and you can get a lot of six different options. Same way here, add beams have different options. We have add beam from point to point, add beam between midpoints, add beams by perpendicular intersection, and add curve beams. But basically, what happens? StatPro does not able to draw curved beam or design a curved beam. Okay, curved beam option is basically not basically available, or it is not done successfully by in StatPro. Curved beam design is not possible. Okay, so add beams. So I go to geometry, add beams, add beam from point to point. So from one point to the other point, I'm selecting the beam. Correct? Like this. Now, another thing. Another option I'm showing you. Geometry, add beams, add beam between midpoint. Okay. So one node. So please select a beam. So first I have to select a beam. Okay. So directly by selecting the beam from the midpoint, I can join a node. That means from midpoint to midpoint, I have to draw two different beams. Then using go to geometry, add beams, add beam between midpoint. So from midpoint of one beam, it will select the midpoint of the another beam automatically. Okay. we can also find out the length of the dimension, okay, the length of the line, how much, how way. Just go to this top option. At the topmost panel, you select this option, display node to node distance. See at the topmost panel, if you can follow my cursor, display node to node distance. There is an arrow, there is a cursor with dot and a red line arrow both ways. So display node to node distance, select this, and you can select two nodes and find out the distance. Okay, and find out the distance. Similarly, you select one node, select another node. 3 meter, half of 3 meter is 1.5. So again, I can get the distance of the line. Always we are selecting the distance from node to node. But unlike in what happens, the same thing we do in AutoCAD using the option DI. To find out the instantaneous distance of a line, we use option DI. But unlike in AutoCAD, we cannot give dimensions in static. We cannot give them, because this is a software based on structural memory. So just we can find out this instantaneous this distance. Okay, that is node, the distance from node to node. Now how to remove this? Just beside this option, that is beside, if you go to top again, display node to node distance, just beside this option, we have another option, that is remove all node to node distance. Okay, remove all node to node distance. Just click this, all the distances which are shown, they will be removed. They will be removed. Okay. So let me watch it. So all these things are there. Now I have deleted this mid beam. Now I want to delete this node actually. Mainly, also I want to delete this node. See here, these two nodes, these midpoint nodes, which have been created, I want to delete. Now whenever I'm selecting using this cursor which is present, this cursor, the only cursor which the arrow, the mouse arrow, which is available in the SCAD Pro, it is the beam cursor. Okay, this white only the arrow cursor is a beam cursor. We can only select beams and columns, okay, and also the edges of slab, edges, beams and columns. But we cannot select node. How to select node? We have to go to this leftmost corner again, node cursor. See here, the leftmost column panel, at the top first option is the node cursor. So you select this, and then whatever we will select, we can select all nodes. We can select all nodes. If you just increase the screen in your from your cell phone, you can see I am just using the node cursor. I am able to select the node. But using this node cursor, you cannot select beam. Only you can select nodes. Okay. So by selecting these nodes, if I put delete, yes, my nodes will be deleted, and also the attached beams along with the node, they will also be deleted. Understood? Again, I'm telling you. For example, I am drawing, for example, okay, so you can delete nodes, the same option, press delete option, and you can delete. So to delete a node, we use this node cursor. If you see the check leftmost or top corner, the node cursor. Below is the beam cursor. Next, to select a plate, we can use plate cursor. Also, we can use surface cursor. So all these things on the future classes, I will show you how we can create and how we can select a plate. So let me first create this plate. Okay. So there are basically, so all these things have been done. If you see the left column again, the second left column, apart from this cursor, the second left column, we have different modes. This mode is the geometry mode. If you select the geometry mode, all the nodes, all the beams, whatever the beams have been created, they will show here. This is the geometry mode, okay? Geometry mode, the basic mode in StatPro. Now, below this geometry, we have general. Under general, if you select, if you see here, under general, if you just below this, under general, see here, we have property, we have specification, support, load and definition, and material. So under general option, we have too many different things. I will show one by one. So first, go to geometry option. Let me complete this grid, okay? So let me, for example, let me increase this thing. Okay, no problem. Let me first join the beams, beam to node, let me join. So let me create the beam, okay? So till now, have you understood everyone? What is the, how to create a node, how to create a beam, all these things? This is a basic thing.
Yes, sir.
So I'm joining this beam, node to node. I'm creating the beams like this, slowly and slowly. So I've made a 2x2 panel. Okay. I have created a 2x2 frame with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So all these are the beams. Okay. Now I want to see the viewing aspect, the different windows or different aspects of viewing to view the screen. I have six different, six different isometric ways of viewing the screen. Okay, six different modes. If you see the, if you go to again, you go to the top panel, topmost corner, the second row. If you go to the second row, we can have, see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have seven different types of view. Where the view is shown by a cube. If we have a cube, we, in the cube, we have six different sides. The front, back, top, bottom, left, and right. Similarly, just like a cube, we have six different sides, and we can view the whole the window in six different sides. Similarly, here also we have front side. See, the first is the front. The front side, it is showing the front side, no problem. Next, on the back side, also the back side will be same because it is a plane frame. The front side is known as view from plus Z axis. Now see, let me show you this thing. This is the isometric view. It is a 3D view you are seeing from an inclined angle. It is a 3D view with X, Y, Z direction. And see, this node which I am selecting is the origin. This node is the origin, okay? Now, if you go to towards right of this node, you have positive X axis, okay? Right of this node is positive X axis. Right of this node is positive X axis. To the left of the node, if you go, to, if you draw any member to the left of this node, it will be negative X axis. Along Y, it will be positive Y axis along the vertical. Upward, along vertically downward, if you go, it's called that is negative y axis, and x axis, z axis. If you talk about, if you come outward of the screen, outside of your that is a laptop monitor, that is called positive z axis, and inside the screen, that is negative z axis. So, first you select the origin, which one is the origin, right to the origin is plus x. Left to the origin is minus x, upward of the origin is plus y, downward of the origin is minus y, towards outside of the screen is plus z, inside of the screen is minus z. Okay, so let us now create this. I have done a 2D frame. Now I will turn it into a 3D frame. See how beautifully I can cut. Now I will use, for example, many students ask me, sir, how to do or how to turn a 2D frame into 3D frame. So there are two ways we can turn 2D frame into 3D frame. First is we have to make a copy of this frame along positive Z axis. Okay, positive Z axis or negative Z axis. That means we have to create, this is done in XY plane, okay? Very interestingly, the screen, with the screen of your this monitor or this laptop is basically XY plane, okay? So, either you can create a similar copy of this frame towards you, that is outside the screen, that is positive Z axis, or inside the screen, that is negative Z axis. So we want to create multiple copies of the same object. So in a linear distance, in a linear direction, either in x direction, y direction, or z direction, if you make a similar copy, that means I'm converting this 2D frame to 3D frame, I will use translational repeat. Mind it the word translational repeat. See here, this I was talking about if they, in the PPT. Let me share the screen. Okay. Let me share the screen. Okay. So this thing I was talking about, that translational repeat. I will teach merge beam and everything. I will show you merging of beam, the third option. That is merging beams means there are two different beams are there. I want to make the two different beams as one single beam. Okay, so I will merge. So I will merge the beam. I will show you later on. So today we will learn translational repeat. Now, if you want to increase the number of bays, that is what is bay? What is bay? Anyone tell me, please. I have taught you in portal method, cantilever method of frame. Just tell me what is a bay in a frame.
Sir, the divisions of horizontal distance in the in any structure is called bay. Not structure, that is called bay of a.
Bay is basically the spacing between center to center distance of column. Okay. Center to center distance of columns. And if the center to center distance between the beams is known as the story height, because it is floor height, and the center center distance between the column, it is called bay. Now, if we want to make a number of, to increase the number of bays along the plane, the 2D plane, plane surface, or if you want to increase the base, I told you the bay distance, the number of bays, the column distance, and also if you want to increase the floor height, that means you want to do a building of 50 story, and you have the same set of column, you have the same center line of column. So will you do the same thing again and again for 50 stories? No, it will be very time consuming. So to copy the same item along vertically or along horizontally, that means to make a floor height, to make different floors, we use translational repeat. Okay. And translational repeat, we will provide some distance of spacing, and by maintaining that distance of spacing, the same items will be copied. Okay. So come to translational repeat, and also we have circular repeat. Translational repeat, and also we have circular repeat. Okay. Now come to first translational repeat. So let me just this thing. Transitional repeat. Circular repeat is a repeat when we do for circular plans. Okay. Circular plans, it is very rarely used. Mainly we will use for, we go for translational repeat, all these things. And after that, I will show you how to merge a beam. We have a lot of options to deal, to do. There are many options to do different tweaks on beams. Okay. So let me first go to the model again. So again, I will be showing my tab of STAD, the STAD window. So this is the thing. Okay. Now first I will create this transitional repeat. I will convert this into 3D frame, and then I will show you how to provide, how we can provide this support. Okay. So what will I do? Let me select the whole thing. I'm selecting this whole thing, and you can, if you see this one from the top, first, second, third, fourth row, this blue colored icon is called transitional repeat. If you see here, if you enlarge it, this blue colored icon, this transitional repeat, there are two ways. Either you can click from here, or you can go to geometry and select transitional repeat. Okay. So you can select anyways. First, you have to select the beams, columns, transitional repeat to select. Now it is asking me in which direction, x-axis, y-axis or z-axis. Now, if since I am wanting it to first make it is done on xy plane, I want it to increase the number of bays. That means I want to convert it from 2D to 3D. So first, I want it to select the z-axis. Okay. Z-axis, first direction is z-axis. Next, what should be the spacing? Let me take the spacing about 2 meters, 2.5 meters. Okay. 2.5 meters. 2.5 meters. So spacing, step spacing, that is a base spacing. Spacing meaning, if you do it in horizontal axis, then it is called the bay distance. And if you do it in vertical distance, that is the vertical direction, in y axis, it will be floor height. Okay. And we all know for residential buildings, the floor height is 3 meter. For car parking, it is 4 meter. And for commercial building, it you may take it about 5 to 6 meters. And also it based on the purpose of the building. Now you select, for example, I want to make a spacing of 2.5 meters. And so I'm selecting the Z direction, Z axis, spacing 2.5 and number of steps. Number of steps meaning how many bays I want to go. Let me check 3. I want to make 3 steps, 3 bays. Number of steps meaning interval. How many intervals? 3 intervals. Default step spacing will be 2.5 automatically. So see, if I put it here 2.5, all of these will automatically be 2.5. And if you want to make some changes, for example, you want to make the first spacing as 2.75, you can do this. For others, it will be 2.5. Okay, just like this. So let me take all these spacing 2.5. Okay, sorry, pardon. I am selecting the transitional repeat, Z direction, number of steps 3, and my default spacing is 2.5. For example, I'm taking 2.5. So Z direction 1, 2, 3, 3 things I have done. Another thing, if you see here, right side, link steps. Link steps means it will join the step. It will join the base. That means the same item you can copy the same item is been copied, but they are not linked. They will be joined only by selecting this option, link steps. Link step. Okay. So by linking step, this option, we can link the copied item. Now you go to OK. See here, it is very nice. We can go. We can, if you use your left and right arrow, from the keyboard. Surely you can see the view. See here. I have done a cuboid, cube. Okay. This thing I have done. Okay. So I have done in Z direction. I have created now. If you want to make some edit, I want to increase the spacing actually. So Z direction. Okay. Meters, number of steps, 4, length step. So this is the thing I can do, one thing, okay? So here, if you can see, we have 1, 2, pardon, 3 and 4. Okay, so see here, I had selected 4 bays, 4 steps actually, so 1, 2, 3 and 4. Similarly, if you see the right side, the beam panel, we have 1 beam, 2 beam. By selecting various beams are selected. 1, 2, 3, 4, all these things, okay. So also the beam number is there. So, while designing or while going for any analysis later on, you can actually access any member element, any beam, any column by using this number. See, the beam number 1 is the first column, 2, 3, 4. Now, 3 is beam, 4 is beam, 5 is again a column. So, later on, to find out, later on to find out the to indicate or to figure out some specific column, some specific beam, what we are doing, we have to click at this beam panel, beam window. By clicking on this, you will able to identify that which is the beam number, which is the column number. Okay. So if I can go here, now I'm showing again the isometric view. Same way, you can now, I want to make another similar copy along, for example, x direction. Okay. So I'm selecting this thing. Translational repeat, x direction, number of steps, 1. Okay. Let us cancel. Let us take only 1 row. So I'm selecting the top view. Okay. I'm going to the top view. I'm selecting this side, and only this side will undergo translational repeat. Okay. I want to increase the number of bays along x direction. Number of steps, let be 3. Number of steps, let be 4 meters. Link step, yes. Okay. So see, similarly, here we are having some bigger way. A broad, type of structure. So this is basically skeletal structure. Okay. Here, no material is given. No density, no material is given. Concrete, steel, wood, nothing is given. Why? So how we can select? You can go to the 3D view. If you see the second row, the pyramid, 3D rendered view. If you select here, the 3D view will be shown. I told you it is a skeletal structure. So it is just like a sketch, pencil sketch. Okay. Because it is just coming like a thin line, because I have not given any material. Okay. I'm not giving any material. That is why it is coming like this. Okay. Okay. So in this way, I have showed you transitional repeat in z direction, x direction, and also let us take some two more floors. Now, how to increase the floor height? See here, you select the topmost floor you want to select. See, I have taken in from the front view. Go to the front view. This will come. If you take the isometric view, if you you will be able to see that the top view or the top slab, the top roof has been selected. Now I want to increase four floors. Okay. So again, I will select transitional repeat, y direction, number of steps, four, height, floor height, we all know 3 meter, link steps. Okay. So similarly, see here, how we have created such a dense 3D complex structure. Dense 3D complex. Okay. Now see, let me show you how we can do merge beam. By selecting different views, you can delete also. Okay. Now I have increased some spacing actually. I have deleted this thing and I will again make a 3D of it and then I will show you this. Now see how we can do the merge beam. I was showing you that we can do merge beam. So there's an option of merge beam. So I was showing in the presentation one. Just wait for 1 minute. So this option, merge beam. So merge beam is very, very a useful tool that, for example, you have two nodes and there is one intermediate nodes, and from that node you have a beam. Two nodes, there's for a single beam. Obviously, for a beam, you always have two different nodes, first at the starting, at the head, and one at the end of the tail. And on this beam, you have one single node. Okay, one single node. So on this node, if you have a beam, and after creating a beam like this, after creating a beam like this pen, okay, you want to delete this pencil. Okay, you want to delete this beam. After deleting this beam, this node at here remains. Okay, so the node at here remains. So this beam, they are separate. And you by keeping these two beams separate, they will be very difficult for you to do structure analysis or finding out the bending moment shear force diagram. We want to merge this. Okay, always remember, whenever you are deleting a beam, you delete the beam, no problem. But do remember the nodes which are still remaining. The nodes which are still remaining, are they hampering the other beams? Are they hampering the other beams? Very important. Okay. This thing we should keep in mind. Okay. So, two different beams. Why we go for merge beam? Merge beam is very, very important option. Actually, when we are going for these two, four, so that the loading applied on the beam, the bending moment shear force diagram coming on the beam is correct, we have to merge the beam. Okay? So similarly, I will merge the beam. Okay, I will merge the beam with these things. Okay. So this option, merge beam option, Now we will learn, okay? Actually, I was telling you that we have a lot and lot of options, lot of tools we can learn from StatCode, okay? So we can stop sharing. Again, go to my stat. Let me present my stat one, stat window. Yes. So see this. So if you see here, so this is basically an isometric view. So you can go to the front view. You can go to the back view, left side, right side. See the yellow side, the sides from which you are seeing, you are able to observe the structure. That side of the cube is yellow color. Okay. That is your eye is from that side. The front side is yellow colored. You can see the front view. Back side yellow colored, back view. Left side, right side, top view, bottom view, and two dimensional. Okay. Now we have to merge the beams by and by. Okay. We have to merge the beams by and by. So just let us, we'll now merge our beams. Okay, we'll merge our beams. So, acha, very important thing, you can enlarge by using your mouse scroll. You can just using this ball of your mouse, scroll ball, you can increase or decrease. Okay. So now we will merge. So this one, we will merge it. So merge, how we can merge? For merge option, you have to go to geometry. The top, again, go to top panel, the top row, the top horizontal, the top control panel. Top panel, go to a geometry. Almost go to this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The sixth option from the last. Sixth option from the last, merge selected beams, merge selected member. So I select the merge. Already, I have selected the, first of all, you have to select the, I selected, go to geometry from top, merge selected members, the two members have, which have been selected, they are named, 295, 296. You want to merge? Yes, merge. So similarly, automatically after merging, you can see, you can see this one, this has been merged. Similarly, I will merge again for the others. These two beams, geometry, select merge selected beams. The numbers are given, merge, yes, close. Okay. Now, another option, that is view selected objects. For sometimes it happens that you do not want to view the whole item. It happens while giving the loading on beams, the loading on slabs. Okay. So what will you take? For example, I'm selecting only this portion. Okay. And I only want to view this portion. So what will you go? You will go to view. You will go to view option from the top panel. Again, from the top panel, from the same topmost panel view, and select view selected objects only, the third option. Okay, the third option. Okay, so only this thing as is available. So by doing this, our only the portion which I have selected, only that portion is available to be observed. But your question will come, sir, what is for the rest of the structure? Do they have disappeared? Have they disappeared? No. How to bring back the original structure? See here. We will go to the second row, this option, display whole structure. Display whole structure. Okay. Just click this, the whole structure will again come. Again, I am showing you let me select this portion. I want to observe this portion only. Go to the view, top view option, view selected objects only. Click this third option and you will observe only this part. Again, you want to see the whole thing, select the display whole structure, this thing. Okay. So similarly, I will merge the following beams. Let me merge all these things. Then I will show you. Then I will show you. We will enter into the by giving the support. Okay. After this, I will also show the stat editor. Okay. Learning how to do a stat editor is very important. Whenever I am clicking the stat editor on my PC or on laptop, it is visible on the screen. It is visible on the screen. But it is not basically visible to you. So I will convert that stat editor into PDF form and then I will show you the PDF. So, again, nothing. Then multiple selection. If you use your mouse, you select one object. While selecting the other object, the previous selected objects, it gets removed. So, while selecting multiple objects, you have to press Control from your keyboard. Okay. Control from your keyboard, and you can select multiple objects. So all these multiple objects which I am selecting, they are red light, they are highlighted by red color, and I am I am using my control option from my keyboard. So my merge option is done. So let me make some transitional repeat towards positive Z direction. I will take 3 steps of 5 meter each link step. Okay. So this is the done. So this thing have been done. My model, my skeletal structure, at least my skeletal structure is done. Okay. So similarly, just like the way all, if you see the right side, all my nodes, all my beams have been shown. Sorry. Nodes and beams have been shown. If you, for example, while doing work or something, for example, I have enlarged this window in a huge, big thing. I have enlarged the node panel, which is on the right side column. So to bring back to the original screen, to bring back to the geometry, while I was drawing the geometric configuration, I will go to the select. Whenever you select this geometry button, the left side, the second of this geometry button, this one, automatically the screen will come. Okay. Automatically the screen will come. Very nice. Okay. The screen will come. Okay. So whenever, for example, it might happen that you are doing some work and by default, a window has been enlarged in a bigger way. So you're not able to get to the screen. You're not able to access the screen. So directly you will go to YouTube. Okay. Till this, I hope everyone have understood how to create a frame.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, in the same manner, you can also create truss. Okay. The same manner, I will give you one homework to how to just, the first thing is that model creation, how to create a model. Designing and all, it will take a lot of time. I don't know how much will it be covered. But basic thing, you have to know that the starting point, the starting path should be known to all of you. I hope everyone is taking the notes in a copy. Now coming to the support. So before going to support, let us take 5 minutes break. Okay. After that, I will show how we provide support. Also, I will show how to provide materials, that is a material property in the on the this structure. Okay, we will use concrete of M25 grade. We will use M25 grade concrete. Okay, so all these things. So we will use M25 concrete. All these things. So based on that, they will use some different values of Poisson's ratio, Young's modulus of rigidity, Young's modulus. All these things will be different. So I will show you one by one. And after that, on a single beam, I will show you how we can give different type of load. Okay. Let us take 5 minutes. ওকে ওয়েলকাম ব্যাক। ওকে ডোন্ট রাইট ইন দ্য চ্যাট বক্স, প্লিজ ডোন্ট রাইট এনি রোল নাম্বার ইন দ্য চ্যাট বক্স, আই উইল কল ওয়ান বাই ওয়ান এট দি এন্ড অফ দ্য ক্লাস, আই উইল টেক দি অ্যাটেন্ডেন্স। ওকে নো প্রবলেম, নো নিড অফ রাইটিং, আই উইল আগেন আই উইল কল ইউ ওয়ান বাই ওয়ান, দেন ইউ উইল ইউ ক্যান রেসপন্ড, ওকে নো প্রবলেম। সো আই হোপ ইউ নট ফিলিং ডিস ইন্টারেস্টেড, অর ইট ইজ আই নো ইট ইজ ভেরি ডিফিকাল্ট টু টিচ চ্যাট প্রো অনলাইন অ্যাকচুয়ালি, অ্যান্ড ইফ ইউ ডোন্ট হ্যাভ সফটওয়্যার ইন ইউর ল্যাপটপ ইট ইজ অলসো বিগ ডিসঅ্যাডভান্টেজ। ওকে ইউ শুড হ্যাভ আ সফটওয়্যার অন ইউর অন ইউর ল্যাপটপ অ্যাকচুয়ালি। বাই হুক অর ক্রুক ইউ আর ভেরি স্মার্ট স্টুডেন্ট, সো আই হোপ ওয়ান ডে ইউ উইল বি এবল টু ডাউনলোড দ্য সফটওয়্যার, ইফ ইউ জাস্ট টেক ফর ট্রায়াল ভার্সন অলসো নো প্রবলেম। ওকে নাও লেট আস স্টার্ট উইথ আওয়ার স্ট্যাড দিস স্ট্যাড উইন্ডো। ওকে নাও আওয়ার মেইন থিং ইজ টু বাই অ্যান্ড বাই ইফ জাস্ট ক্লোজ দিস স্টপ শেয়ারিং। লেট মি শেয়ার দ্য পিপিটি। Other things like view selected objects only, this thing also what should I say, the accessory by the subsidiary items which we follow while doing the stat. View selected objects only, this thing is important, already I taught you. Whole structure, bringing the from observing the whole structure, from observing some portion of the whole structure by using the option of view selected objects only to whole structure. I showed you that which are the options we have to select. Cut section I will show you while giving the loads on slabs. Grid I told you, there are some of the other less important items like shade, duplicate structures, rotate, move, all these things I will show you. Now, first is we will provide support specification and assigning. Support specification, I told you the first thing, if we can follow this chart. This chart is very, very important. What is given this chart? This chart is given this model generation and analysis. Model generation and analysis. Okay, next, input geometry, that is nodes, beams and plates. So we will generate the model and analyze and design the whole scheme or whole flow chart is given. Input geometry, node, beams and plates. Input properties means after giving the node, beam, supports, we will properties means the dimension, the dimensions of the beam, the damage of beam, the damage of the slab, column. Then input constant, supports, support condition, input loading, obviously loading is important, analyze, and all these things are there. Okay, so this is a complete flow chart of how we can conduct the analysis as well as the design part. Very, very important. Okay, this very important area where Viva can come. Now we were talking about support specification and assignment. Okay. Now we all know that there are three different types of supports. We have roller support. We have roller support where the number of unknowns are one. We have pin support or hinge support where the number of unknowns are two, that is Vx and Vy. That is the reaction and the horizontal thrust, the horizontal force, The two are unknown. In roller support, the horizontal, the vertical reaction is unknown. And in fixed end, the fixed support, we have three different unknowns are there. Fx, Fy, and Mz0. So all we know the basics of structural analysis as far as supports are concerned. Okay. Now we will start with, so having this knowledge of supports, we will now provide supports on the bottommost nodes of the building. Okay. So I hope the screen is the visible to you all. Okay. Now, first to do supports, what we will do? So see, if the whole body is grid form, it is a completely grid form. All the nodes are joined end to end. So first, I will take the front view. First, whenever you have a plan, you will take the front view, and you will select the all the beams at the bottommost floor. You select all the beams of the bottommost floor. Just select this thing, just like this. Take the front view or any view. Select. See, I am taking not any other view. I am just taking the front view, and see, using a box, using my my selection option is an area. I am taking not a single piece. I am not selecting like this. I am selecting a huge area. Okay. A selection can be from left to right, no problem. Selection can be from left to right or from right to left, okay? No problem, just like in auto. So by selecting this, you see here, all the beams at the bottommost floor have been selected. Now I will delete. Because this is the floor level, this is the foundation level, sorry. This is the foundation level where I want to give my support as fixed end, okay? So, at the foundation level, we don't have this beam. Yeah, sometimes we provide tie beams, then we have to keep these beams, okay? For example, if you go for strip footing, or I should say strip footing with tie beams, that is an example of shallow foundation, then we can keep this beam. We can keep this beam, okay? We can keep this beam. But if you don't, mainly what we do, we do not keep this beam, because if there are no tie beams in the foundation, we do not keep this beam. Okay, so we just select, we take the front view, we select this, and we will just delete this, delete, enter. So see here, all the bottom beams, all the beams at this foundation. So this level is basically the foundation level. Okay, mind it. It is not the first floor level. It is, sorry, basically it is the foundation level, and from the foundation level till the first floor height. Okay. So this height we will take, this height, this one, this height we will take from the foundation level till your column level. Okay, till the first floor level. So now I will provide supports. So how to provide supports? All how to provide the fix, we will provide fixed end support at all the ends, all at once. Okay. So go to now come to general. So all our tasks in geometry screen, in geometry mode is over. If you see this geometry mode is over. Okay. This geometry mode is over. Now we have to go for general. Below this geometry, we have general option. Going to general, we have another option. Below the general, we have support. See here. There was geometry. Geometry, so we will select general, and we will select support. Okay. Now support, we have to create a support. There are three different types of support. I told you roller. Mainly we have roller, pinned, fixed, sometimes we have spring support. So we will create a support. You see, there are a lot of options are there. We have foundation option, under foundation we have L, W, length, width, and subgrade modulus. So all these things will be taken care by geotechnical engineer. Mainly our will be fixed. See here, we have different options. We have foundation option, inclined, tension or compression only springs, multilinear springs. That means if we use dampers, if we use disc, if you use dampers, dampers are basically the base isolation technique which we use to isolate the base foundation during severe earthquakes. So dampers, they contain springs. Okay, they contain springs. So for those we will use the spring constant and everything, all those things. But for normal RCC building design, we will directly go for fixed end. We will select the fixed. See here, Fx, Fy, Fz, Mx, My, Mz. Because it is 3D, 3-dimensional frame, so we have 6 degrees of restraint. 6 restraint in 2-dimensional, we have 3 restraint, and in 3-dimensional, we have 6 restraint. So Fx, Fy, Fz, Mx, My, Mz. So we will add. So see, spontaneously, this addition have been done and the support have been enlisted here. That means the support have been come have come, has entered into this bucket list. Okay, support has entered into this bucket list. So I will see, so first thing we have to create the support, extend support, enlist this thing here, select this, and then we will select all these bottom nodes. See here. We will select all these bottom nodes all at once. See, all the bottom nodes have been selected. So basically, we will put, or basically, we will attach the fixed support to the nodes, right? We cannot attach the fixed support to the beam. We have to attach if there is any node. Node is a juncture. I told you, node is a point where we can provide, where it is a beam column joint, or where we can provide the support. So we just join this, just we are selecting. Again, I am showing you, take the front view, select, keep this thing selected, select all the nodes of the bottommost node have been highlighted as red. Now, if you want to check, you can take the 3-dimensional view and you can check this. Then, so there are 4 options assigned to see here, right side bottom. Assigned to selected nodes. Assigned to selected nodes, first option. Second is assigned to view. Use cursor to assign. Assigned to selected nodes, assigned to view. Use cursor to assign and assigned to edit this. So the first option is that is assigned to view. The second option means if we select this and assign, then all the nodes on the structure will, the fixed end will get attached to those nodes, all the nodes. But if we select this assigned to selected nodes, only the selected nodes, the support will be get attached. So select this option, assign option. Do you want to proceed? Yes. So see here, instantaneously, if you check, all the supports have been attached with the fixed end. See, the fixed end, we can show the fixed end like this. All the columns, if you check properly, all the columns have been supported with fixed end. Okay, so this is the first thing I will provide fixed up. Now, since it is the foundation of a building, we are providing fixed up. Now, if you are doing a truss member, one member will be roller, one member will be hinge. Okay. We all know truss members are pinned members. They are pin jointed. They are never fixed jointed. They are pin structure, right? We all know that a truss member is a member which does not take the bending moment. They only take the shear forces, the axial forces, compressive as well as tensile. And also another thing that is, they are always pinned or hinge support. They are not fixed. Okay. So, understood how we are providing the supports?
Yes, sir.
So
Yes,
we
sir.
are providing, supports like this. So we are at, the bottom most, at the bottom most level, first I will take the front view or any view, front view, select all the beams at the bottom most level, delete all those, and then so the nodes will be there. So you create the fixed end, and I'm attaching the fixed end with the support. So the first thing, always remember, before giving any material or something like this, after creating the geometry, the second thing is your support. Okay. Now the third thing, the material. The third, that is material. Okay. So let me, so I will use concrete material here, and I will use somewhat like for example, I will use you can now the grade of steel, they do not require the grade of steel at the first. They require the concrete grade. Here, for example, I will be using like M30, M25 concrete. Okay. So first, now is the material specification. First is geometry, second is support assigning, and third is material specification. Okay. So I hope everyone is taking down the notes, because all the notes which you have been taking down, you have to submit in the Google Classroom. Okay. This will be a process of evaluation. Okay. All of you, I'm telling you from day one, you have to keep a notebook. You have taking the notebook, you have to scan the pages. After our classes is over, then you will upload this in your Google Classroom. I will create an assignment, and you have to upload this. Okay. After supports, second is property. See here, under general, so property, under general option, we have property. Okay. Okay, so now we will give the material property. That means what will be the concrete. First of all, what will the item? The item will be timber, steel, aluminium, concrete, all these things. Second is the grade of concrete, all these things. So if you want to check the material, see here, the third column from the left side. The third column from the left side, see the bottommost option is material. You select the material, you click this. So what are the different type of material is available in the market or available in the stack? We have steel, stainless steel, aluminium, and concrete. If you double click this concrete, there are some prefixed Young's modulus, Poisson's ratio, density, all these things are given. Okay. All this we have to modify. Okay. All this we have to modify. So first, let me, I just wanted to show you that what is the material available in the stack. So you click on this material, we have steel, stainless steel, aluminium, concrete. If someone wants to input copper, or if someone wants to add another extra material like copper or something like composite material, composite material you can do. Some portion you select concrete, some portion you select steel, no problem. But if you use different type of material, then you have to go to the coding part and you have to do the coding. Okay. Now first, so let me take all the beams. I'm just generalizing. I am taking all the beams as 250 by 400 mm, 250 width, 400 depth. Okay. 250 mm width, 400 mm depth, and columns also 300 by 400, for example. So sorry, I am taking the beam as 250 by 500. Okay, let us see. So now go to this property. I told you we will go to this property tab. And since we are doing RCC section, we have to go for define. We have to go for define since it is RCC section. If it is steel section, we have to select database. Select database. Again, I'm telling you, since it is RCC section with proper depth, width, then we have to go for define. Here we have circle, rectangular section, T section, all we have learned in RCC, rectangular beam, T beam, trapezoidal beam, you can put general type of, then tapered I section, I beam, tapered tube section, and assigned profile. Okay, so all these things are there. So basically, as an RCC designer, we will always select a rectangle. Okay, so this is for RCC. For RCC design, we use define. And for steel, we will select section database. Okay. Now under section database, see a steel. So for steel, we always go for section database. If you see this, we have American steel joists, Australian, Brazilian, we have Indian. So we will be focusing on India. Just we are selecting the Indian code. We have S shape, we have ISLB. Then if you want I section, I shape, all these I section will be there. Okay, so all the sections are given, ISLB, ISMB, ISHB, all sort of rolled steel section you can select from here. Okay, you can select from here. So we are here focusing on RCC design. So we will go to define and rectangle. I told you we are taking two different, we will group two. First is all the beams as two, around 250 by 500, 250 width, 500 mm depth. And the columns are 250 by 400 depth. Okay. So rectangle C, YD. YD is the vertical Y axis or the depth along Y direction. Depth along Y direction. That means the depth. The depth, let me take for beams, for example, it is in meter. Please mind it is in meter. So since the depth of beam is 500 mm, so the depth in meters, how much it will be? 0.5. Right? I don't know what will happen.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The depth is 0.5 and my width is 250 mm. 250 mm, that means 0.25. So 0.25, okay. So I've given 0.25 meters. I told you from the day one that since at the beginning of the software, we have selected a meter and kilonewton. So that is why everything is in meter, depth and height. So we have to make our mind in that manner. So we will add. Instantly, when you are adding here, if you see the right side, you will get a rectangular section, material concrete, 0.5 into 0.25. Okay. So in the bucket list, just like you have bucket list in Amazon, you have bucket list in Flipkart, similarly in the bucket list, it will come here. Again, another section we will take for columns, 0.25 by 0.4, 0.45. So this thing I'm adding. So 0.25 by 0.45. So I have created two different rectangular sections made of concrete. I have not mentioned the grade of concrete. Please mind it. I have not created or I have not mentioned the grade of concrete till now. Only I have mentioned that yes, I will use concrete section. Okay. In the STAT editor, I will do the editing. So first I will select the beams. So how will I select the beams? Come to the front view. Come to the front view, or you can go to the top view also. You just using the, just so what will you do? Now we will, so we have created the bucket list of the different cross sections. We have created a bucket list. Now the second thing is that we have to assign this section. So select the member and using control, we are selecting all these beams. We are selecting all these beams. See, all at once, my beams are getting selected. Horizontal beams, beams will be in horizontal axis. So along Z direction as well as in X direction. See, you can do this by two ways. Either you can go to top view and you can select all the beams along X direction and also along Z direction. That means to select the beams, you can do two ways. By doing this manually, you can do this. Or if you want to do, so this here, there is any other ready-made way, because this is a very, this is one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 story building, 5 na 6 story, G plus 6, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, this G plus 5 story is a 6 story building. Okay, now for example, you are designing for 50 story, 130 story, or 500 story. So what will you do? How, so you will manually select. It is very difficult. And here the plan is a regular plan. It might take place sometimes that the irregularity in plan can be it sometimes in T section, sometimes in X section. So what we'll do, we will go to select option. See, at the top panels, go to select option, beams parallel to X, select option, beams parallel to Z. Okay. Doing this, assign to selected beam C. So there are two ways. Either you can do it manually or you can do it another. I'm showing you again. You have to go to this top horizontal row, select beams parallel to X, select beams parallel to Z. Okay. So see, if you want to check all the beams have been selected. Now I have to assign. Same way, assign to selected beams. Here it is selected already, assign selected beams. Assign, do you want to assign? Yes. Now see all the beams of R1. Now, the stat pro, they don't understand rectangular concrete. They will understand by this name, R1. See, reference one. So reference one, under reference one, what is the rectangular member? Rectangular 0.5 into 0.25. So my stat pro, all these beams, they will understand that yes, these are all reference one member. If you go to 3D view, see, very interestingly, since I have provided my property, cross section, all the beams have taken a three-dimensional structure. They are not now scatter structure. They are all three-dimensional, okay? Three-dimensional thick beam. Again, for columns, you can either manually select columns or directly go to select beams parallel to Y. Columns are basically the vertical member. So beams parallel to Y, you select this, assign to selected beams, assign, yes. So now my whole structure has got its very nice, so beautiful view. So this is the three-dimensional view. So this is what we call as frame structure. The new technology or the technology we use for design, we use for limit state design for the last 20 years in RCC technology. Framed structure. So this is the frame structure we have been learning from the day one of civil engineering. That means the majority, 99% or 95% of the load is taken by these beams and columns. Now this frame structure, they can be of OMRF, ordinary moment resisting frame. If you just design as according to IS 456, it is OMRF, ordinary moment resisting frame. And it will be, if you are designing for ductile detailing, we can mention it as SMRF, special moment resisting frame. Okay, so those are all different things, but basically this is the frame structure. With no infill valve, very important. Here we have not created any infill valves. We will not create an ascendry valve. We will create the frame structure, and on the beams, I will provide the load of the bricks. Okay. So now, important thing. So now I have put this concrete, all these things. Now, come to now, we will change something in the study. Stat editor, I will show you. For example, just now let me make a printout of the stat editor. Because this stat editor is not visible to you. So let me show you how the stat, whatever the commands we have used, all they are stored in static data. Just and stop sharing. Let me find out my file where I have saved my file. So yes. So now I'm sharing the PDF format of this stat editor. Okay. So see everyone. So what is the form of this stat editor? See, all the joins, now this you have to learn. All the joins, the joint numbered, see, the stat space, my first, the file where I have saved my file, very important, this will come. Then the name, all these things, joint coordinate, that is the coordinates of X, Y, and Z coordinates of various joins and various nodes. So first is the node number and then the coordinate 0, 0, 16. That means 0 x meter, 0 y meter, and 16 is my T. 16 is my z direction. Okay. All these things, then member. So for various joints, for example, for joint 37, these are my coordinates. Similarly for joint 60, these are my coordinates. So this is the way you should learn how to write. In examination, we will give you that, we will give you a truss member or a 2D frame or a 3D frame or small frame, and you have to write the incidences. This is called joint coordinates or joint incidences. This is the program. This is the program thing. Okay. Next, coming to member incident. Also, member is very important. We will provide the members, the name of the members, 85, 37 to 40. That means first is a member name. See, for example, I'm taking the name, the number, for example, 90. Okay. 90 is the member number. And what are the in between which nodes they are lying, 45 and 44. So this is very important. Okay. So like this, we separate all the beams with the semicolon. Okay. And we have space also, the beam number, space, the first node, the second node, okay, like this thing. Next, we will come to material. See here, we will come to material. See here, if you check the PDF file, the material isotropic concrete. See here, E, Young's modulus, they have taken some value, random value, okay? Some random value, this Poisson's ratio, Young's modulus, Poisson's ratio, density, FCU, that is the complex strength of concrete. All these four items, E, Poisson's ratio, density remains same. For any grade of concrete, density remains same. Young's modulus, Poisson's ratio, the dampness 0.05. And strength, they take a random value. They are taking 27,579. If you see this, they are taking a value of 27,579. That means they are taking a concrete strength of, whose concrete strength is 27,579 newton, sorry, kilonewton per meter square. That means 27.5 newton per millimeter square. But we need, now see here, this is the difference. We need, they automatically by themselves they take a value. This is not correct. This is by default value. We as an engineer, since we are doing our M25 grade concrete, all the beams and columns will be M25. So now it is our task to change this value. So I just wanted to show you this. I just showed you this stat editor just to show you that the change before the change and after the change what will happen. Okay. So now it is your task. Everyone will help me that for RCC design, we need to change some of the things like Young's modulus, কংক্রিট কম্পোজিট স্ট্রেংথ, পয়জনস রেশিও, অল দিস থিংস। ওকে, নাও উই উইল কাম টু আওয়ার বোর্ড, হোয়াইট বোর্ড। Okay. Now see here. Everyone, can you see the board?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see
sir, no,
the
sir.
thing.
Sir.
Okay. See the thing which we mainly focus. See here. The thing which we mainly focus, that is instead. Please, everyone, take this in your copy. Or else your learning of StatPro is completely zero. You will be able to learn many things, but these things no video will show you. I guarantee you this. This is a guarantee of Saurav sir. This is my challenge. I have taught, I teach in different centers. I have taught many students for the last 4 years. I have an experience. I teach my students. This is the basic thing. They do the mistakes. In StatPro, especially in RCC. Can you see the board?
Yes, sir.
Absolutely clear, toh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, youngs, now, what is the grade of concrete we have? The grade of concrete we have is M25, for example. Now, M25, okay? So, M25 means, what is the compressive strength? FCU will be 25 Newton per millimeter square. That is the characteristic strength of concrete at the end of 28 days. 25 Newton per millimeter square. So this we will convert into kilonewton to meter square. Because all the items in the stat, they take in kilonewton and meter. So this, you convert this thing. 25 divided by 1000. Whole divided by so millimeter square to meter square. That is 10 to the power minus 3 whole square. Just put in your calculator and find out the values.
25 into 10 to the power 3.
25 into 10 to the power 3, correct. So whatever the value of grade of concrete we will get, that we will just multiply that with 1000. Okay, always remember. This I am showed you since you are learning for the first time. Okay. Learning for the first time, that is why I have showed you. Okay. From the next time, whatever the grade of concrete, just multiply it with 1000. Where are the others? Momita, Sagni, are you listening to the class?
Yes, sir.
I will take on just I will take further 10 minutes. Okay. I know it is very I know as a student it is very difficult for you to keep the patience. As a teacher also, it is very difficult for me to go and talking and talking. But this is a thing which I wanted to show you. This one, FCU. Now, Young's modulus, what is the value of Young's modulus as per ISO physics? All of you must know. You have given gate examination. Follow. What is Young's modulus? 5,000 root FCK. What are the gate aspirants? You should know this thing, na? 5,000 root FCK. This thing is comes in Newton per millimeter. So this, the first we find out the value, 5,000 root FCK, 25. What is the value you tell me? What is the value you tell me? 5,000 root FCK, 25. So this 25, This 25 FCK, this FCK, you will put this value. That is 25 into 10 to the power 3. Sorry. This thing you will put and you will find out the Young's modulus. Tell me the answer. 5,000 root, this one. You have a calculator, please find out. quickly.
790.
790.
569.
790, 569. So this is the value of Young's modulus you will put in STAT editor. This value of Young's modulus, please write in your copy. This FCU 25,000, because there we do not put the units, only we put the value. Okay. And Young's modulus is 790,569. Please write it in your copy. So this is the value we are going to put in our STAT editor so that the RCC design should be correct.
Sir, what if we directly put FCU?
Just pardon. I'm not getting any request in my desktop also that you are trying to join. Okay, I'm showing it from a cell phone, that is why I'm not able to join you. Even I went to my laptop, but I couldn't find any. Okay, no, you have to put two values. FCU value bhi put karna hai aur EC value bhi put karna hai. Isiliye I found out these two. Okay. And what about Poisson's ratio, mu? Poisson ratio for concrete gate aspirants value kitna hota hai concrete ka? Quick range batao, range batao, tell me the range. You cannot tell me the Poisson ratio of concrete. What? And you are giving me you are giving gate examination, IS examination. Horrific avastha. You don't know the basics. 0.2 to 0.3.
Sir, 0.20.
0.2 to 0.3. Yeah. So you can take an average value. You can put 0.2. You can take a 0.25 and as an average value. The Poisson ratio of concrete is 0.2 to 0.3. It's a very basic MCQ for any examination in civil engineering. A very lucrative area of question. Poisson ratio of rubber, Poisson ratio of steel, all these things. So this Poisson ratio, write in your copy, 0.25, EC 790,569. So this value we have to put in our STAT editor. Okay. So I will show you in the STAT editor. I'll show you the STAT editor by putting this, because in the STAT editor, whatever changes I'm doing in the laptop, that you will not be able to, that is not visible in your cell phone or in the video. Okay. So I will do the changes. And I will again take the PDF and I will show you what is the changes. Okay. Already I show you the change of PDF before changing and after changing. If you do not do these changes, whatever you do, the design, the whole design will be wrong. Everything will be wrong. This is a fundamental area. Okay. So everyone taken down in your copy, you see all this thing.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, now we will be again going back to our PPT or our STAT window, and I will show you. So today this is the thing we are going to learn, and on Thursday I think I will do the changes and I will show you in the class today only. And on Thursday Devanjan sir will take your class from 2 p.m. Okay, just wait, do not leave.
सर वाइवा में क्या सब पूछा जाएगा?
आदित्य प्लीज डोंट आस्क मी एनी इररिलेवेंट क्वेश्चंस. आई विल व्हाट एवर आई एम टीचिंग यू एटलीस्ट फ्रॉम माय पार्ट आई विल बी आस्किंग फ्रॉम माय लेक्चर क्लास ओनली. ओके, डोंट नो यू हैव ग्रोन क्वाइट ओल्ड, यू हैव बीन ऑलमोस्ट टाइम टू पास आउट. So irrelevant question, Aditya, is not expected from you. Okay.
Sir, এই যে recorded videoটা এটা একটু upload করে দেবেন
classroom. Yes, absolutely. I will upload the recorded video after I take your attendance. After I end the meeting, then the record comes after 1.5 hours. 3 hours recording, and
थैंक
that
यू
is
सर
why they taking the pain to record. Okay, they have taken the pain to
थैंक यू
record
सर
this thing, and I will upload in my YouTube channel, or I will mail you. Okay, if I am not able to upload in YouTube channel due to some problem in internet or due to some internet capacity, data capacity, I will surely mail you. Okay.
স্যার ক্লাসরুমে আপলোড করলে ভালো হয় স্যার তাহলে
ওকে
তাহলে
আমি
তো
আপলোড ইন
ডিলিট
দ্য
করতে
ক্লাসরুম।
পারি
ওকে অ্যাকচুয়ালি ওয়ান থিং ইজ দ্যাট দিস আপ দিস রেকর্ডিং কামস ফ্রম গুগল হেডকোয়ার্টার্স ইন মাই মেইল অ্যাকচুয়ালি ওকে নাও আই ক্যান ডু সাম শেয়ারিং ওকে নো প্রবলেম আই ক্যান ডু সাম শেয়ারিং তো ওকে আই উইল ট্রাই মাই লেভেল বেস্ট টু টু গিভ ইন দ্য আপলোড ইন দ্য গুগল ক্লাসরুম নো প্রবলেম
Thank
Yes,
you,
because recording is very much because I am rushing through, but you have to take some time to digest. So now the main thing is that the values which I have got, I will do the changes in the static editor. Okay, so directly I will go to isotropic concrete. E value is what is the E? What is the E value? 760589. What is the E value?
So
790569. This one Poisson's ratio, it was given initially 0.17. I am making it 0.25. Density, we all know density of concrete, more or less the unit weight of basically the unit weight RCC, it is 25 kilogram per meter cube, so we will put the density as 25 more or less. Dampness remains same. FCU, characteristic strength, this will change as 25,000. So I'm making the change, I'm saving it, and I'm again making it a printout. That is PDF form. I'm taking it out and I will show you in the screen. So now again I am sharing my screen of PDF. If you see, I have this the SCAD editor. Again, I have taken only this portion, the portion which I have made the changes. See the E value. The E value I have made the change. Can see the values. E value I have made the change. I have made a change in Poisson 0.25. I made a change in density and this strength 25,000. So based on the grade of concrete design, based on the concrete design. Now see why this is very important. Now see why this is very important is that whatever the grade of concrete. See IS 456:2000. Is highly based on the grade of concrete, because if you take the value of the lever arm XU max by D or XU by D or the moment of resistance MU as given in annexure G, you remember IS 456 annexure G. So in those areas, if you really identify the formula, everywhere there is a factor of grade, the FCK and as well as FY. If you do not provide the FCK properly, it will be very difficult for us to do the design properly. Even if your structure is absolutely correct, your loading is correct, there will be a problem, and you will never be able to understand where your problem is. Okay, so this is the thing which I want shared with you from my last 5 years experience of teaching my students. Okay, so now I will take the attendance.
স্যার একটা কোশ্চেন আছে স্যার
বলো
স্যার মেটেরিয়ালের মধ্যে গিয়ে আমরা যদি ওখানে কনক্রিটের উপর ডাবল ক্লিক করে ওখানে যদি আমরা এফইউটাকে এফইউ এর গ্রেডটাকে 25 25 000 কিলোনিউটন পার মিটার স্কোয়ার করে দিই স্যার, তাহলে তো অটোমেটিক্যালি ওটা নিজেদের মতো করে সফটওয়্যার নিজের মতো করে ক্যালকুলেট করে নিচ্ছে, তাহলে তো আমরা করতে পারি।
না সফটওয়্যার, ইফ ইউ সি দ্যাট সফটওয়্যার উইল নট এবল টু ক্যালকুলেট, ইউ উইল ডু দ্যাট, ট্রাই দ্যাট ওয়ান, ঠিক আছে, এবার ট্রাই করে দেখো,
আচ্ছা স্যার,
সফটওয়্যার ক্যালকুলেট করে না, ওটা একটা স্ট্যাটিক প্রবলেম, ওকে
আচ্ছা 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 ঠিক আছে স্যার।
জাস্ট ওয়েট আ মিনিট, জাস্ট ওয়েট। Yes. Tell me,
Sir,
yes.
could you tell us something regarding the marks distribution? Because we know the classwork is already there, the Viva will be there, but will we have to do some hands-on work as well?
See, actually, after discussing with Dona Madam, I will surely inform you as soon as possible what is the marks distribution or what will be the process of evaluation of exam. Okay. After discussing with Dona Madam, I will surely mention you, inform you within this week only. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Now it is attendance time. Let me take the attendance. What is the starting roll number?
Say 86.
86.
Yes, sir.
87.
Present, sir.
88.
Yes, sir.
89, 90, 91, 92, 93,
yes, sir,
94,
yes, sir,
95,
yes, sir, 95,
96,
yes, sir,
97, 98,
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. 97.
97. Okay. 97. 97. Yeah. Please be attentive. Please give one time. 98.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. 99. 100. 1.
Yes, sir.
2.
2, sir. 2.
100 ko to 100.
Sir, 101.
101. 102.
Yes, sir.
Okay, 103.
Yes, sir.
Roll number 100. 100. 4. How much? 100 what? Roll number what? 103.
103, sir.
103. Okay, thank you. 104. 5. 6.
Yes, sir.
106,
105, sir. 106,
107,
106 given, 706.
Okay, sir,
thank you, sir.
8, 9,
9, 10,
yes, sir.
10.
11,
10, sir.
12,
111, present, sir.
Okay, 112, Abhishek Pal.
111, sir.
111, okay. 12, 13.
Present, sir, 113.
13. 14.
Sir, 114 present.
15.
Yes, sir, 115 present.
16. 17. 18. 19.
Yes, sir, 119.
Those who have given attendance, you can leave, okay? 120, 21.
So 21 has gone to give his interview, so Arsalan.
Sir, 22. Sir, 22.
Yeah, just a minute. Just a minute. Yeah, 121. 122 K. Pijada.
Sir.
122. Pijada, you are having some problem. Sija, you most probably having some problem regarding the backlog paper on environment engineering or something like that, air pollution, please rectify. Please rectify that problem with your faculty members. Okay. Okay.
পাঠিয়ে দেবো একটু পরে মেলে
দেবাঞ্জন স্যার নিচ্ছে, ঠিক আছে, জানি দেবাঞ্জন স্যার কি পড়াবে।
আচ্ছা,
দেবাঞ্জন স্যার পড়াবে, আমি তো আমার পথে চলবো আর কি। আজকে যত অব্দি থামলাম, পরের দিন এইটাই আবার এগোবো, ঠিক আছে, পরের দিন এটা এর উপরে লোড দেব, ডিজাইন করাবো, ঠিক আছে, বেসিক একটা বিল্ডিং কিভাবে ডিজাইন করে এটুকু আমি মোটামুটি একটা আইডিয়া তোমার কাছে পেলে তারপর তো পরবর্তীতে তো
সেই স্ট্রাকচার উইজার্ডের ব্যাপারটা স্যার ওই জায়গাটা না যেটা বলছিলেন না,
হ্যাঁ,
ওই যেটা হচ্ছে শিফট করে করে এক্স এক্সিস ওয়াই এক্সিস জেড এক্সিসে, ওটা স্যার লাস্টে স্যার ওখানে কানেক্ট গুলো কি করে করছিলাম